For problem 8, we have this set of equations, and we are asked for a system that would fit them. In the case of the first equation, we can easily see that we have an acceleration in x and the mass of an object. So you can infer then that this sum is just sum of forces in x. And below, you can see that you're including the weight of the object and the normal force, so then you can infer that this is just the sum of forces in y, which is zero, so it means that it's not moving up or down. Then you see that you have, for each coordinate, a component of a force that's making an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. So if we were to do the free body diagram, we could start with the force at an angle of 30 degrees and with a magnitude of 100 newtons. Then you see that the force of kinetic friction is opposing movement on x, so you end up having that in this direction. Then normal goes up, as this again has a negative sign and it's just the weight, so it goes down the weight. A problem that could fit these equations is somebody pulling a box with a rope making an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal and applying a force of 100 newtons total. This way you have the normal working on it just from the ground, and then the friction is there between the surface of the box and the floor, and you have the weight. Then you can also notice that the third equation that you're given is a description of your kinetic friction. And if you remember, how you get kinetic friction is multiplying the coefficient times the normal. From here, it's easy to solve for mu as f of k over n, which if you solve for here, you'll see that it's just 0.2. So then, as an extra detail, the coefficient of friction between your box and the floor is 0.2. Okay. We already have the free body diagram, and now we're asked for the acceleration. We can solve for that first on the first equation as 100 newtons times the cosine of 30 degrees minus whatever friction force is over 20 kilos. Then we're going to use this equation to solve for our friction force. So we end up with 30 minus 0.2 times the normal force. Now the normal force we're gonna get from the second equation, since it's the only variable we have there. We end up getting 100 by 20, we'll get 5 meters per second squared times the cosine of 30. And then we have 2 times n over 20 kilogram. You see that if we divide this factor by 20 kilograms, we'll just get rid of this term, and in this case, this will give us the same 5 meters per second squared as here. So you'll end up with something like 5 meters per second squared times the cosine of 30 degrees. I forgot a minus sign over here. Squared minus 5 meters per second squared times the sine of 30 degrees. You can then factor 5 meters per second squared sine of 30 plus 0.2 sine of 30 minus 0.2 times 9.8 meters per second squared, and that will give you a total of 2.87 meters per second.